Welcome back to Upfront. We're continuing our discussion of the Tuesday recall primary with a look at the challenge facing Democrats. The Democratic candidates for governor, Milwaukee Mayor Tom Barrett, former Dane County Executive Kathleen Falk, State Senator Kathleen Vineout, and Secretary of State Doug La Follette faced off in their only televised debate Friday night. The latest Marquette University Law School poll shows Barrett with a commanding lead over Falk and in basically a dead heat with Walker among registered voters and likely voters. But defeating the governor won't be easy, no matter who the Democratic candidate is. We're talking more about this now with Mike Tate, chairman of the state Democratic Party. Chairman Tate, good to have you back on the program.
Glad to be here.
Whoever the candidate is, you're going to face a huge financial disadvantage in this race. Mm-hmm. What do you do about that?
Well, it's a stunning financial disadvantage. You know, Scott Walker has raised $25 million, spent 20 in pretty much the last year. But for all that money that he spent, he, you know, hasn't really done a very good job of making up ground with the electorate. I think that this is going to be one of those rare circumstances where while we, you know, are going to spend money and are going to need money, we're not going to be able to compete. But I think that's not going to matter as much.
How badly outspent do you think you'll be?
Oh, multiples to one, you know, 3 and 4 to 1, if not more.
At least.
And I think that, again, this is, most people know who they're going to vote for. The average Wisconsinite, I'd be surprised if there's many people watching today that don't already have an opinion about Scott Walker one way or the other. And it's about turnout. This is about who's coming to vote. It's less about how many TV ads can you run.
Are you convinced that let's say Tom Barrett were to win this primary, and that's not a foregone conclusion by any means, but if he did, are you convinced that public employee unions are going to work enthusiastically to get him elected, or is there going to be the passion will not be there because of things that he has done in his negotiations with public employees?
I think that there is no question that whomever the Democrats nominate is going to do everything within their power to repeal Act 10 and many of the other terrible things we've seen Scott Walker pass in his time as governor. And I firmly believe that all of organized labor is going to be 110% unified and engaged and fired up between whomever comes out Wednesday night. We're not going to see some gap of time. We're not going to see some gnashing of teeth. People are 110% ready to go for whomever wins that primary on Tuesday night.
You just mentioned Act 10, restoring collective bargaining provisions. Mm-hmm. Should that be front and center in this campaign once we move on to the June 5th election?
Well, look, it's clearly an important issue. I think that it's, in many ways, the issue that sparked so many of the movements and excitement we've seen this year. But it's by no means the only issue. You know,
well, you're talking jobs now, aren't you? Isn't the conversation about jobs and not about collective bargaining?
Well, I think it will be about that? I think the conversation is absolutely about jobs. I think it's about education. I think it's also about collective bargaining. You know, you talk to the approximately a million people who signed the recall petition, Mike. They had many different reasons for signing. Collective bargaining was one, and I think jobs was another and probably a pretty important one.
When are your candidates going to start talking about how they would have dealt with the $3.6 billion deficit? They've talked a lot about what they don't like about what the governor and Republicans in the legislature did, but less about what they would have done. It was a big task. When are we going to hear that?
Well, I think we've seen candidates start to address that, and I think that once we get through this primary, you know, we're going to have our Democratic candidate is going to be talking about his or her vision for the future of Wisconsin, how they would do things differently than Scott Walker. And I think it's going to be a pretty clear contrast and one that I'm very excited to see made.
So they're going to be able to talk about, if we're going to restore funding for education, we would cut here. They'll be able to make those kind of distinctions?
Yes. I mean, and I think that whether it's we would cut here or whether it's we would, you know, close some of the corporate tax loopholes we've seen Scott Walker open up that haven't created jobs, that haven't brought business to Wisconsin, I think there's going to be a lot of, it's going to be a very solution-oriented campaign, and it's going to be a big contrast between the radical agenda Scott Walker's pursued and the positive unifying agenda our Democrats going to present.
I want to have you address this notion of mischief in Tuesday's election, that some Republicans might try to influence the outcome of the Democratic primary for governor, or might try to really affect the outcome of the Democratic primary for lieutenant governor. Do you have any concerns about that?
You know, not really. It's something that I've talked about. It's obviously my job to be concerned if there's something to be worried about. I think that, you know, Scott Walker's in a primary of his own. Arthur Cole Riggs is running, and I think that he may garner some genuine Republican support for people who are Republicans, but unhappy with where Scott Walker's
taking their
party. You
think he'll get Republican support in that primary?
I don't think any Democrats are going to be voting the Republican primary. We've got a great primary on our side. But look, I think there's Republicans out there that are unhappy with what Scott Walker has done to their party, this radical agenda he's pursued. And I think it's possible they may make a statement in that Republican primary.
Give me a sense of how this process has played out for you. I think a lot of people figured that at some point the Democrats would turn on each other and would take their fair share of shots at one another.
Mm-hmm.
That really has not happened. Have you strongly encouraged each of the candidates to stay away from that kind of behavior?
Well, look, it's not just about what I've said. Of course, that's what I want. But I think there is just such a overwhelming desire and sense of purpose that this is not about, you know, Tom Barrett, Kathleen Falk, Kathleen Vinehout, and Doug LaFollette. This is about beating Scott Walker, bringing the state together again, restoring our values. And it didn't need to be said to anybody involved in this primary that the ultimate goal is to make sure we defeat Scott Walker, bring Wisconsin back together again, bring jobs back here. It wasn't a heavy lift. People
you haven't gone to candidates or campaigns and repeatedly said, don't go there, don't go there. You haven't done that?
I have. I've had a lot of conversations with campaigns, but I can tell you that every single one of those good candidates is, and their supporters, are unified behind beating Scott Walker, and understand that the best way to do that is not to tear each other down, but to talk about your own positive vision and let the voters pick our candidate on Tuesday.
Mike Tate, the chairman of the Wisconsin Democratic Party. Good to have you back on the program. Thanks very much for being with us. Next, what insiders are saying about the primary. We'll get the view from journalists who covered the Capitol. And tell us who you think will win the Democratic primary for governor by liking up front on Facebook.